Hello YouTube world, this is Alex the Gaming Teacher, and welcome back to my blind run gameplay of Mafia 2. Alright, well, that last episode started as a mess, and it was pretty ironic how when I killed a couple policemen, stole a couple vehicles and such, and the whole chapter was being in prison. Of course, not the reason why. Reason why you went to prison, but alright. Oh, what do you know? There's no more snow. Yay! So I was hoping for. I mean, the scenery is nice and all, but it just felt a little hard to see where I was going. Okay, what's this guy? What happens if I do something here? Wait, oh, I can't punch. Can't do anything. So where's this room at? Is this one? Oh, no. Okay, it's up here. The fudge?
Hey, you break out of jail? Ah, jeez, good to see you in regular clothes and on the right side of the bars again. Welcome home. Come on in, come in, come in.
Man, I tell you, lots changed since I went away.
Yeah, I guess it has. And hey, it ain't much, but I hooked you up with a nice little apartment, just like you
Thanks.
Said. Now I got a surprise for you. I'm going out tonight to celebrate, and I'm going to introduce you to somebody.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
You're going to need a little cash so you can get things going again. I got a piece for you, too, if you want it. Ah, here. Always comes in handy. So, what do you want to do now that you're a free man?
Hey, what do you think? I want to go back to working with you again.
All right. I was worried they might have turned you straight in there.
I actually met a lot of people and learned a lot from the inside. A much better idea about things working.
Good thing, because I wasn't exactly sitting around on my ass while you was in there. Don't worry, though. I'll show you the ropes, like always.
What are we waiting for? Let's go.
Jesus, I didn't expect you to be raring to go like this, but what the hell? Come on, let's go see your new place. We'll take my car and go meet your new landlord. You do the driving so you can get back into the swing of things. Just hope you didn't forget how to drive while you was in the can.
Hey, what are you worried about? It's like riding a bicycle.
Sure, but when you smack up your bicycle, it don't cost a fortune to fix the friggin' thing.
All right, I get it. You're like an old lady.
Yeah, I sure as hell hope so. And if you ain't noticed, cars are a lot different since you went away. You'll see. Your new place is just down the street, right near the boardwalk. You're gonna love it.
Okay, where's I supposed to get a vehicle out of here? Alright, Friday are still damaged. Jeez. Should we go with the hot rod? Yeah, let's just do that.
Damn, it's good to have you home. I've done pretty good while you was locked up. But now that you're out, the sky's the limit.
You seen Henry lately?
Nah, not for a few years now. He really felt bad about what happened, you know.
Oh, what you been up this way?
We couldn't really talk about much more this way.
Well, after the shit Clemente and that little asshole Luca tried to pull on us, I got hooked up with the Falcone family and I started working for them.
Really?
Yeah, you'll see tonight. I told you, I got a nice surprise for you. Don't bother asking, because I ain't gonna tell you.
Oh, boy.
Don't worry. I've been planning this for weeks.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Did something happen because I went on a red light? I don't know. It's just the police car right there, so I'm like... What's new? It's like you get out of prison, you don't want to get in trouble with the police already.
close enough to park here. Go check the place out. It's on the top floor. I already paid the first month's rent for you. And hey, the entrance to your garage is on that side street over there.
Thanks, Joe. I appreciate it.
Hey, and about tonight, we're going to a real classy joint. So buy yourself a nice suit. They won't let you in this place look like an ex-con.
My kind of place.
What the hell? Why is that lady just standing there? Okay, so new apartment on the top floor. So now we have our own place, pretty much. Oh gosh,
okay,
that's a lot of stairs.
Here we are. I'm sure you'll find it to your liking. I live in a similar apartment myself. As you can see, it even comes with a telephone at no extra charge. And here's the bathroom, clean and modern, with all the hot water you could ever want. And here is the master bedroom, and there is the master's bed. It's comfy, with room enough for two, maybe three. And it doesn't squeak. Always a plus in my book. I sure hope you like your new apartment, sir. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Just one question. When are you leaving?
Now, if you'll pardon me, I have to go and check on another client. Goodbye now.
Yeah, see you.
Dressed into a suit. Okay, here it is. It says a suit, but I wear the new thing I bought. Wait, what? Casual suit and a hat? Yeah. Okay, go to Joe's. My guessing is that we can't really punch anybody inside a building, so wait, what light could I turn off? Alright, I'm ready for some action though. Garage is on the left around the corner. Oh, here? What the heck is this? Different cars? No. This one. I guess, oh man, the thing is, the other vehicle is, yeah, I left it right there. Whatever. Wait, what's the song again? Cruising and playing the radio with no particular place to go. Just wondering if I could tell him to get out of the way. Yeah, this vehicle looks a little sketchy, but okay. Chopper said, in memory of somebody, so I wonder what that means. There's no credit action so far, but then that last one was just like, eh. I think it was just maybe learning a little more about fighting. That's pretty much everything. That's what was happening all throughout. No particular place to go. So we park way out on the Kokomo. It's certainly not one of the more difficult parts of the game though. So we like if I just kept counterattacking and then.
Can you imagine the way I felt?
What are you doing? Alright, let's see here if we have anything now. I do. Just the small one, though. See, I know there's another area we can enter, but I always keep entering from the backside. It's whatever.
Jeez, I thought you was gonna be a no-show. Not bad, nice material.
Thanks. So, what's the plan for tonight?
You'll find out. A friend of mine's coming to pick us up. I met him when you was on your little vacation. And show him some respect. He's kind of an important guy.
Oh, yeah?
You'll see in a minute. Here he comes.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Eddie. Here I am. How's it going?
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. What, is your buddy?
Yeah, this is my pal Vito. Vito, this here is a good friend of mine, Eddie Scarp.
Nice to meet you, Eddie.
Same here, Vito. Okay, fellas, I'm dying for a drink. Let's go. Hey, Vito, you want to drive? I had a couple of drinks already. So, you tell him where we're headed, Joey?
Nope. All he knows is that it's a surprise.
Just trying to...
he's gonna love it.
I fucking hope so. Unless he got into the, funny business in the can.
Hey, what are you two talking about?
Don't worry about it. You'll see.
Hey, come on. We might as well tell him now.
Hey, you waited this long. We'll tell him in the car.
Wait, who's driving? Oh, I guess I was.
All right. Let's go, Vito.
Hey, you know, it would help if you told me where we're going.
Head to Oyster Bay.
Okay,
so Vito, what was the one thing you missed the most when you was in the camp?
Freedom.
Yeah, well, but besides that?
Now, you know, booze, broads, baseball, everything.
Now you're getting closer.
What, are you guys taking me to a baseball game?
No, we're taking you to the classiest cat house in the city, Vito.
Cat house, huh? Wow.
Whoa, you don't sound too excited, Vito. Come on, don't tell me you don't want to have some fun after all that time.
Hey, don't worry, Vito. These girls are real professionals. If you forgot how to do it, they'll get you back in shape in no time.
We're gonna have a ball. Oh, hey, remind me not to drink too much. There's something I gotta take care of later.
What's more important than pussy and booze?
You know how it is. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, Vito, come on, step on it, eh?
Yeah, well, that freaking truck. Jeez, man. Okay, let's speed up a little bit. Oh, I see that. Must be, like, for a repair shop. It's alright, man. As long as there's no, police nearby. I could definitely drive faster. Oh snap. Ah. Okay, it's right here. What evil star is my.
So I talked to Leo Galanti about you, Vito. He said you were a real stand-up guy, and he told me all about the shit that Clemente tried to pull on you guys. But between you and me, why'd you get into that line of work? I mean, we all got our reason.
Well,
Yeah.
Because, you know, I don't want to end up like my old man. And,
oh, no. Yeah.
Look, I figure nobody's gonna help me, so I gotta help myself.
You do. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Scramble. So, Vito, listen. I work for Carlo Falcone, and we're looking to expand our operation. Joe's been working for us for a while now, and since you're a friend of his, we'd like to extend that offer to you as well. What do you say?
Yeah, sure, I'm interested.
All right, let's drink to it. Here's to you guys. And to a bright future together. Touching down. I can't be drinking too much tonight. I got some business to take care of. Carlos, he's into, you know, astrology.
You mean astronomy?
Fuck you, you fucking cum dumpster.
Sorry, ladies. Looks like I gotta get going.
Shut your goddamn pie hole. If you wanna use your mind.
You fellas ready to go?
Yeah, let's go. Hey, get up, Joe!
If you had to prepare 20 years ago, you wouldn't be a walking up.
Oh my goodness.
Hey, I'm going. Good night, you whores!
Okay.
Hey, where the hell is my car? Somebody stole it. Hey, call the fucking cops, man.
You're staring at it, you lush.
Huh? Oh, yeah, good. Hey, where's my keys?
Vito's gonna drive. He's the least fucked up out of all us.
Yeah! Next time for us, Joe. More pussy, less poos.
Not to say, how are they gonna get in? These guys just started driving off.
So, how'd you like the place, Vito?
A lot better than playing I just zeech in the shower, huh?
What the hell's that stink? Eddie, you puke?
What? I wouldn't puke in my own car.
What the hell is that smell then?
Oh, yeah, I'm smelling it too.
Must be Frankie Potts.
What? That asshole puked in your car?
Nah, he's in a trunk.
What?
What?
Hey, it's all your fault, Joey. I told you I had some fucking business to take care of, and you went and got me drunk.
Hey, since when does business to take care of mean dead guy in the trunk?
Hey, whoa. Hey, calm down, Vito. Hey, I expect we'll figure something out.
What's to figure? All we gotta do is bury the stiff. I already got a spot picked out, up by the old observatory.
Got a shovel?
Sure, it's in the trunk. And the hole is already dug. All we need
they
to
did
do
say
is chuck him in and cover him up.
All right. Where's this hole?
Yeah, a little ways outside of town. There's a path in the forest to a small clearing. That's where the hole is.
And hurry it up, will ya? God, I need some fresh air. The stench back here is fucking killing.
Gosh, seriously.
Oh, stop. Now, I'm gonna hurl.
CLA, Empire Bay's news home. I'm Gary Stevens. Mental freedom for Empire Bay.
Okay, why do I feel like I'm driving much further now?
With a new release of what they're calling a credit card.
Too late
to go. It doesn't seem right.
Christ, Eddie, that fucking reeks.
Oh, hey, it's his car.
Yeah, but that smell, plus the other smell. The only way it could get worse now than me craps himself.
Okay, I'm not sure what the heck is going on.
With hardly any repercussions down the road. For Empire Bay's news leader, ECLA, I'm Gary Stevens.
And every time it rains, and it's from heaven.
Shooby dooby!
Don't you know each cloud?
Ready to just look at the map. I don't understand. First of all, you need to. Oh, fudge. Okay, let's see her quickly. Alright. For some reason, it's just a very long drive. Ooh. I feel like something's gonna happen though. This can't be the whole chapter, just driving around. Jeez, why the heck? Where the heck are we? Ooh. What the heck? Am I supposed to do that? Okay, so...
Alright, we're here.
Vito, go pop the trunk.
Is that a joke? That's great. That's just great. Yeah.
God damn it, new shoes. Jesus Christ.
Fucking Christ almighty. How long this guy been in here, Eddie?
Just a couple days.
You're gonna have to get him out of there, Vito.
That's just great.
I can't handle the smell.
Some fucking welcome home this is.
Hey,
mother.
Hey, here's the hole.
Right here. Dump him in.
Finally, done. Okay. Now who's gonna bury him?
What?
I give me a minute to get a hold of myself. Can you just do it? Every time I get a whiff of the guy makes me have to puke. And Eddie's not gonna be any help here.
Fine, whatever.
Hey, fellas. How about a little music, eh?
You gotta be kidding me.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to.
This wasn't supposed to be part of your homecoming party, but it's nice out here, ain't it? Well, I ain't been in the woods for a while.
Yeah, you won't be liking it so damn much after I smack you with this shovel.
Okay, well, the fudge, why did I feel like police were gonna... I don't even know what's going on now.
Oh, Vito, do not change that.
Take the drunks back to Joe's.
Huh?
Yes, that's all it is. Let me see, this is definitely... yeah, it's gonna be a long drive. Was supposed to happen just as we crashed into that gate.
Hurry back, I am yours. Return to me. Oh, my dear, watch you only. Hurry home, hurry home, hurry home.
Are they singing to this? I feel like I don't want to switch the song then.
My darling, if I hurt you, I'm sorry. Oh, forgive me. And please say you're mine.
Ah, man, that was close.
Turn to me. Please come back, Bella Sophia. This is the best part.
So I'm gonna switch it now.
Hey, come
oh,
on,
I can't
Vito,
switch it for
you. Know this song, right? Yeah, let's go. Here we go. Oh, shit. I don't know the fucking Italian slurs. Ah, fuck, where's my motto when I get
solo two, solo two, solo two.
So I guess, yeah, driving through red lights doesn't do anything, but I don't know if it was this game or Watch Dogs where you could adjust it, the cops would just pull you over for almost anything.
Sorry, Vito. Not exactly the best way to end the night, huh? But thanks. I owe you one big time. Leave Eddie's car here so I can get home in the morning.
You're a good man, Vito. I'll settle up with you tomorrow. Hey, you coming in for some drinks?
It's 3 a.m. Shut the hell up!
Hey, shut up, you whore! Come on!
You had enough, Eddie. Going to bed. Come on. I'll call you tomorrow, Vito. Good night.
Okay, I'm guessing we have to drive home now. Or no, this is going to be the end of the chapter. I'm guessing the guy they just buried was Francesco Potenza. Well, that was a very low-key chapter as well. Okay, the wild ones. Maybe this is gonna be something.
What the fuck?
Hey, Vito, rise and shine!
Jesus! Buddy, stop fucking yelling, will you? My head's killing me.
Sorry, Joey.
Stop calling me fucking Joey. What the hell's wrong with you?
Vito, come on down!
Jesus Christ.
Okay, I want to go with a different outfit though. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe eventually we'll buy another outfit. I'll just stick to this one. Unless I'm gonna do military again, I don't know. Ah, geez, we're all the way on the top floor, so conserve electricity. Wait. Oh.
Who the hell was that? Guy's got a voice like Woody fucking Woodpecker.
That was Marty. Remember the little kid used to live down the street from me? I had to pick up the truck here, so he gave me a lift.
What's going on with the truck?
It's gonna make us some nice cash. Hop in. I'll explain on the way. You drive.
Where to?
Riverside.
All right, Riverside it is.
Okay, drive to Riverside. Don't damage the goods. Oh boy.
Some night, huh?
Yeah, you could say that.
Why? You ain't still mad, are you?
Nah, very in a stiff. That's the first thing I wanted to do when I got out.
Hey, come on. You had fun at the cat house, right?
Yeah, I did. Thank you for that. But, everything between then and now, not so much.
All right, all right. Well, listen, today's gonna be a lot better, I promise.
I sure as hell hope so.
Oh, snap. Set that damn to good, so we're here. Yeah. Sure, don't get into any accidents. Same time though, the truck might be going really slow.
So what's the deal?
Simple. Just gotta go to a couple of places and unload these smokes. Then we bring the truck back to Eddie and get our cut of the tape. Piece of cake.
Wait. I seem to remember getting thrown in a clink for a piece of cake just like this.
Don't worry, I've done this before. First stop, Riverside.
Say so.
Trust me, you're gonna thank me later.
Oof, no. Wait, is this one a joke for now? Am I going on the highway? Dang it. See how. Why is that just in the camera? I don't even remember what they said the press adjusted on. Okay, maybe this is really going like under in the tunnel. Oh. I think it made the car actually kind of go off to the side. Oh, snap. Oh. Do we even have any money though? I'm just like thinking about like going here.
Are you looking to buy a gun or you just need some ammo?
Let's see. No. It's definitely, yeah. We need to get more money before you even think about it.
Bye-bye now.
Delta radio. Don't touch that dial.
Oh snap, it's his car right there. Another one walking in the streets. Was a close one.
What now?
Now we take care of our customers. These guys here buy in bulk from us. Come with me. Okay, climb up and hand me the goods.
Hi, one carton of Reds.
Hand me a carton of Reds, Vito.
Okay, what am I supposed to press?
Move it, Vito. Carton of Reds.
Okay, chill. I'm just gonna call you Phil, but.
Bingo!
Yeah?
Here it is, sir. You're welcome. Come again.
Hey, good to see you. I'm all out of smokes. Give me a carton of blues.
One carton of blues, Vito.
Alright. White.
Hey, hand me a carton of blues. Yeah, that's the one. Here.
Just getting $2 out of this, though? Well, yeah, I was about to say, we're not gonna do that over and over again. Uh-oh.
What the fuck?
Please.
Hey, Sarge, how you doing? Caught in the blues as usual?
I think I'll take the whites this time.
Wait, what?
Get that Vito. Let's go. Caught in the whites.
Is this one right here?
Yeah, that's the one.
Okay, what the heck's this
Thanks,
about?
Joe. Now get the hell out of here, will you?
Okay, time to go. Get in, Vito. Next stop is Millville. It's going great.
Oh my gosh, what?
We're making some serious dough here.
Yeah, I mean, we are definitely getting a lot of money, I guess, out of this. Oh, brother. Jeez, why the heck did it make a rapid spin like that? Yeah, get out of my way. And police car, policeman standing nearby. Alrighty.
So, the kid Mark, he works for Eddie too?
In his dreams. Kid's not even 18 yet. He does jobs for me, drives me around, makes deliveries, that sort of stuff. Thinks he's a gangster though. Spends too much damn time with him.
Well, the kid's got you for him. He's in for a lot of trouble.
Oh my gosh, he's freaking kidding me. I wasn't even looking at the road.
A lot of you will use his age.
Exactly. I spent 3 years dodging bullets in Europe and 6 years in the
kitchen.
That's what I mean by trouble.
What's the matter? Somebody shit your coffee this morning? It's like you forgot about all the good times.
Yeah, remind me of something, would you?
Yeah, man, this truck's going really slow. Let's see how much we have to drive. I'm like, freaking out, are you serious? My goodness. I would like to try to just avoid restricting my speed, but I don't know. Shouldn't be driving this fast with this vehicle. Yeah, we do that. Alright, gotta be careful on these turns here. On a highway, we shouldn't have to worry about. Policeman. No, unless we're on the other side. Oh, freaking gosh, no. Because if I keep going. Oh my gosh, yeah, that would take forever. Yeah, so we're just gonna be doing the same thing again.
Hear that whistle, it's
Yeah, I guess it looks like it.
Give me a cotton of blues.
Yeah. Customers?
Yeah.
I'm so eager, I'm nearly dying. I hope there's not a third part. Third place we have to go to. Uh-oh.
What you selling, Mac?
You buying or just window shopping?
Maybe.
We're selling smokes. $2 a carton, $100 a crate.
I'll make you a deal. You fuck over 10 cartons and maybe we'll let you and your buddy get out of here in one piece.
Hey, look, pal. How about you get back in your cute little car with your little friends there and I'll pretend I never seen you. Sound good?
You don't get it, do you, you fat motherfucker? This is our turf. And it's gonna cost you to operate here. Now pay up.
You're the one who doesn't get it. You have any idea who you're talking to? One last chance. You walk away now and...
Yeah, I'll tell you who I'm talking to. A fat two-bit fucking dago door-to-door salesman hocking stolen cigarettes on my turf. And it's time to close up shop, asshole. Okay, boys. I think it's time for a fire sale.
Oh, boy.
Shit. Joe. Oh. Fuck. What do you say now?
What do I gotta say?
That's right.
Oh, boy.
Come on. Hop in that car and let's go. Alright, let's get one of these fucks and teach him a lesson.
Catch the greasers? Oh
step
my gosh.
On it, Vito. He's getting away.
I got it floored, Joe. This thing won't go anywhere.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Now we are officially chasing. Dang it. Maybe I shouldn't have spoke about this. Like, I don't mind doing easy work. Cause look at this, I can't even freaking control this car.
Ah, shit, no.
Shit, we should check in with Eddie. Stop at the nearest phone booth and call.
Okay. There was no way I was gonna catch it. Like, are you serious? We gotta find a phone booth. I need to get off this highway for one. Jeez. Okay, you know what? I think if we go to... They don't show it on the map? What the heck is this? Oh, it's home. Alright, well... Just go on the streets? Oh, there's one. $540, make a call. Yes. How much does it cost?
Eddie, it's me, Vito. Listen, we got a problem. We were moving the smokes, and then these greases came out of nowhere and set the fucking truck on fire.
What? You fucking kidding me? You couldn't handle a bunch of grease balls? What the fuck happened?
Look, Eddie, listen, it's not our fault, okay? They set the fucking truck on fire before we knew what was happening, and everything burned up. All right, we popped one of the guys, but...
What do I fucking care? Just bring me my money. I paid $2,000 for that truck, and I want it back. Lucky for you two retards, I got Derek's guy Steve here with me. We were just talking about what to do with those punks. We're gonna take care of them now. Steve will meet you at the Crazy Horse. You know it?
Okay, Crazy Horse. Yeah, I know where it is.
Steve's gonna have a few guys with him. Show them that nobody fucks with us. No shooting, though, so it looks like just another gang fight. I don't want to read about a bloodbath in the papers tomorrow.
All right, sure, Eddie. Don't worry. We'll take care of it. All right, we got to meet Steve in front of the Crazy Horse. Good news is he's going to help us out. Bad news is, Eddie wants his money back. All $2,000 of it.
Shit! You really think we're gonna get $2,000 out of these guys?
I don't know. We'll see what Steve's got in mind. You know he ain't doing this out of the kindness of his heart. Let's go.
Great thing. Great thing.
For Empire Central Radio, this is Rockin' Ricky Fox.
Oh my gosh, this is gonna be another big drive.
Eddie was fucking pissed on the phone.
Sure he was. Just like I'm pissed right now. Even if these assholes ain't got a dime, I'm gonna kick $2,000 worth of shit out of
him. I'm with you. But what's Steve doing working for Eddie? He works for Derek, and Derek's with Vinci's crew.
How the hell should I know? But hey, you're still gonna take jobs from Derek, right? Even though you're working for Eddie? We all gotta do what we gotta do to get by.
I'm just like, please get me through the police car without bumping into it. Alright, he's gone. Let's floor it now. Alright. There we are.
Hey, Steve.
Hey.
Hey, guys. Marty? What are you doing here?
Hey, Joe. I'm going with you on this one. Steve needed help. He said I could come along.
Steve, isn't this,
Kid's gotta learn sometime.
Okay, why are we here, Steve, huh? The guys we're looking for are all headed to the foundry.
This is where they usually meet, so we'll start here. Then head over to the foundry to finish the job.
And, why'd you volunteer to help us?
Those bastards trashed my cousin's car. They robbed him and knocked out three of his teeth.
Yeah, those fucking assholes. They make problems all over the city.
Shut up, kid. Talking here. So like the Bible says, an eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth. And well, we'll just start with this joint.
So what's the plan?
First, we're gonna trash this place.
And how are we gonna do that?
With this. Go ahead, boys.
Hey, come on, guys.
Now you can either help us or stay out of our way.
Let's go teach these fuckers a lesson.
What the fuck was that?
This is insane. Can't shoot anybody, can I?
Okay, that's enough. Let's lead him over to the prison. Vito, Marty, I got some Molotov cocktails in the trunk. Go get them and throw them in.
My pleasure, Steve.
Wait. Oh, I ran out of bullets there? Okay, take a Molotov from the trunk. What? Okay.
What are you waiting for? Grab the bottle and chuck it in. It ain't that hard.
That'll teach him.
All right, now we go to the foundry. Get in, boys. We'll meet you two at the main gate.
See you there.
Drive to the old foundry. Okay, well, I'm gonna probably cut this short, though. Yeah, it's all good. I'll just let this play out. Hopefully no cops come over here. Alright, so thank you guys all for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, then please give it a like. Subscribe to my channel and click the bell button as well. I think I'm gonna start just saying click the bell. Y'all know, already know what I'm talking about in this case. But on that, stay safe, and I will see you all next time.